हेलो चिल्ड्रन, सो टॉपिक हियर इज एवरेज पावर इन एन एलसीआर सर्किट। सो एज वी ऑलरेडी नो, इन एन एलसीआर सर्किट इंडक्टर, कैपेसिटर एंड रेजिस्टर आर कनेक्टेड इन सीरीज टू अ सोर्स ऑफ एसी। सो इन द प्रीवियस टॉपिक In the previous video, we have seen that in an LCR circuit, either inductive voltage is more than capacitive voltage, or capacitive voltage is more than inductive voltage, voltage across inductor. And in this case, voltage leads by phi and current lags by phi. So equations are written as sin omega t minus phi, and in the other case, that is in this case, voltage lags by phi, that means current leads. So equation of voltage we do not change, so we will write as it is. If you wish, you can denote by I as well. So here current is leading by phi. So anyways, in case of LCR circuit, either current is lagging or current is leading. So we can, like right now we have to find out power in an LCR circuit, so we can take either of the equation. Okay, any one we can take, or you can simply write in an LCR circuit, current either leads or lags by phi. So we can write equations like this: sine omega t plus minus phi. Now say one equation you pick now of the current, whichever you feel comfortable. So I am picking, let the negative wala equation I am picking. So I naught sine omega t minus phi. So now we know this is the equation of voltage and this is the equation of current that I have chosen. Now my power is equal to VI. So let us substitute the value of V. And I now power can also be written as dw by dt, that is rate of doing work. So rest of the equation as it is, V naught I naught sine omega t, and this can be opened. Sine omega t minus phi can be opened. And how is this opened? Sine A minus B, sine A minus B, sine A cos B minus cos A sin B. So we will take dt that side, and we will write dw is equal to V naught I naught. Okay, we are opening the bracket as well. So it is sine square omega t cos phi. Dt will go that side, so dt with first term, and then dt I will write with second term also. So now multiply V naught I naught sin omega t cos omega t, this is sin phi, and then dt. Now dw will be written as V naught I naught. This term is without t, so you can write it before the rest of the terms, sine square omega t dt. Okay, similarly you can write this first. So it is V naught I naught sine phi, because it is not containing a term of t, and then it is sine omega t cos omega t dt. Now we'll multiply and divide it by 2. You know why we are doing, because it will be sin 2a, then 2 sin a cos a. So now we'll have to integrate. So we will be integrating both the sides. Okay, it's over full cycle, so you can put limits as well, 0 to t. Now dw's integration is w, v naught, I naught, cos phi out, and sin square theta can be opened as, those who don't have mathematics, they have to learn, 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2, then dt. So this is opened as this, and from here it's v naught, I naught, sin phi out, and it is 2 sin a cos a, yani ki sin 2a. This is sin 2 omega t by 2 can also be gone out. It is 0 to full cycle dt. Now see, here also we have two terms. First of all, you can take this out. So what can be written as v naught, I naught, cos phi, 2 is also out. Okay, here we are 1 into dt. This dt I have given to both the terms. And minus, let it be common. So this is integration of cos 2 omega t into dt. And similarly, this is second term, this is closed, v naught, I naught, sin phi by 2. Now listen, this is sin 2 omega t, its integration will be minus cos. So plus, minus, minus, plus, cos 2 omega t by 2 omega. This is how we do the integration. And limits are from 0 to full cycle. Sin's integration is minus cos, minus went here, so minus minus was plus, and this is cos 2 omega t, so what is written with t will also come down. Now coming to next step, let us see, this is 0 to capital T, this is also 0 to capital T. See, directly if you can learn it, then learn, sin's or cos integration over full cycle is always 0. This is cos to the power 1, okay? And it is sin to the power 1. So sin's integration over full cycle is 0. If you can write directly, it's good. And cos integration over full cycle is also 0, because the average value of both is 0. So we can substitute 0 here and 0 here, because this answer will be 0. So directly we are left with one term. If you wish, you can skip. Otherwise, you can follow your steps of integration. So I am ready with this result. Its integration is small t. So this is small t. Limits are from 0 to t. Now in the next step, we will open work as power into time, average power into limit difference of time. So t minus 0, this is equal to v naught, I naught, cos of phi by 2, and it is t minus 0, upper limit minus lower limit. This is cancelled with this. So I am ready with average power as v naught, I naught by 2 into cos phi. So this average power can be written as, this is v naught by root 2, then it is I naught by root 2, and it is cos phi. Now दिस इज वी आर एम एस, दिस इज आई आर एम एस एंड दिस इज कॉस फाई. सो एवरेज पावर इन एन एल सी आर सर्किट इज गिवन बाय दिस फॉर्मूला एंड दिस ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक टर्म इज नोन एज पावर फैक्टर. कॉस फाई इज नोन एज पावर फैक्टर, डिटरमाइंस पावर लॉस. सो एंड वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन फ्रॉम इम्पीडेंस ट्राइंगल, इफ यू रिमेम्बर, दिस यूज टू बी जेड, बेस यूज टू बी आर, इट वॉज एक्सएल माइनस एक्सी. सो कॉस फाई दिस इज पावर फैक्टर इज इक्वल टू आर बाय जेड. सो दिस इज एवरेज पावर डिसिपेटेड इन एंड एल सी आर सर्किट. नाउ वी हैव टू डू स्पेशल केसेस. नाउ विल डू स्पेशल केसेस. Special cases. When the circuit is purely inductive, when circuit is purely inductive, then what do we know? That voltage leads current by 90 degree. That is, phi is 90. That is, cos phi is 0. So we'll substitute here cos phi. So we'll get average power as 0. Cos 90 is 0. So average power in purely inductive, that is AC circuit containing inductor only, purely inductive circuit, is 0. In case of purely capacitive circuit, here current leads the voltage across capacitor by again 90 degree. And what is the value of average power? What is the expression? VRMS, RMS voltage into RMS current into cos of phi. Phi is 90, cos 90 is 0, so average power is 0. Okay, now coming to case number 3. Case number 3 is your purely resistive circuit. In case of purely resistive circuit, that is AC circuit containing resistor only. So in that case, you know voltage and current both are in same phase. Voltage and current both are in same phase. Both in same phase, that is zero phase difference. That is, phi is 0 degree, cos 0 is 1. So my average power will come as VRMS into IRMS. So what do we see? That in case of purely inductive circuit and purely capacitive circuit, average power is 0. That means the current flowing in them does not dissipate any power. Current in purely inductive and purely capacitive does not dissipate any power. So that is called, that gives you the name of wattless current. Like power consumption is 0 for such current. So that gives us the name, the term wattless current. So what are wattless current? You will say general formula of power is in an AC LCR circuit is VRMS IRMS cos phi. In case of inductor, current leads sorry, current lags voltage by 90, so phase difference 90. So wherever phase difference is 90, power is 0. So that power, that current does not consume any power. So that current is called wattless current. Okay, then we have LC circuit. It's important. Go through the topic very sincerely. LC circuit is a circuit in which inductor and capacitor are connected. No battery. Just look. There is no battery. And capacitor is fully charged. We will take the capacitor fully charged. So what happens in LC circuit? When fully charged capacitor is connected to inductor, as soon as we plug in the key, we complete the circuit, capacitor starts discharging. As we complete the circuit, capacitor starts discharging. Yani ki it starts losing its electric field one by one, one line and then second line, and current starts flowing in the circuit. Okay, now current is increasing because charge is decreasing here. And this inductor's nature, you know, it will produce induced EMF because current is changing due to self-induction. So there are two voltages. One voltage is across the capacitor, which is Q is equal to CV. So V is equal to Q by C. And one voltage is here, that is induced EMF, which is equal to, we know it, that it is equal to minus L di by dt, if you know. Because flux is directly proportional to current for inductor. Flux is equal to Li for inductor. And E induced EMF is equal to minus d phi by dt. So, yes, we know. Here, this much EMF is there. So, this capacitor, which was fully charged, is converting its charges, is getting discharged and converting into current. Current is rising. So induced EMF is produced. There are two voltages, one this. So because there are two voltages in the circuit, so we'll use using Kirchhoff's voltage law. So what is KVL? Voltage across capacitor plus voltage across inductor is equal to zero. Sum of voltages is zero. So what is first voltage? It's Q by C. And what is the second voltage? It's minus L di by dt is equal to zero. So Q by C equals, or let it be, now see, I'll tell you, this current can be written as d by dt, first of all you write as it is. And current can be written as dq by dt. That is the definition of current. If current is rate of charge. So current can be written as dq by dt. But here we will write current as minus dq by dt. Because when charge is decreasing in capacitor, when charge is decreasing in capacitor, negative sign is showing that current is rising in the circuit. So we will write it as minus dq by dt is equal to 0. So this can be written as q by c plus l d square q by dt square is equal to 0. Now I am simply rearranging the terms, d square q l by dt square plus q by c equals 0. I am dividing each term by l. So I am dividing by l, l and l. So I know that this will be written as d square q by dt square plus q, and this is 1 by lc, is equal to 0. Now this equation is that of SHM. SHM's general equation, general differential equation of SHM, which we did in class 11th, general differential equation for SHM simple harmonic motion is, do you remember what is the equation? So equation is d square x by dt square plus omega square x is equal to 0, or y can be there. So you can write this equation is quite comparable. This equation is comparable to that of SHM. This equation is equivalent, comparable. In fact, is this equation is general equation of SHM. So it means in LC circuit, something is oscillating. LC circuit is producing oscillations. That is what it do. This equation is that of simple harmonic motion, simple harmonic oscillation. It means LC circuit is producing oscillatory motion, oscillations. We will see that later on. So right now, omega square can be compared to this. So the frequency of the oscillations of LC circuit is omega square is equal to 1 by LC, and omega is equal to 1 by root LC. This is natural frequency of LC circuit. Natural frequency of LC circuit. See, by chance, this formula is quite similar to that of resonance, but here resonance is not occurring. This is not LCR circuit. This is LC circuit, and there is no battery. So then you can further open it as 2 pi nu if you wish. It is equal to 1 by root LC. So what is important here, that LC circuit and inductor and a capacitor, fully charged capacitor, when are connected, then they produce oscillations, signals, EM signals, electromagnetic signals. Whose frequency is this? What is oscillating here? Actually, the capacitor was fully charged. So, initially, every energy is electrostatic energy. Right, capacitor was fully charged, so all the energy is electrostatic energy. And how it is stored in the capacitor? In form of half CV square. When it is connected to the inductor, then it starts discharging and it current increases. And here, the inductor induces EMF, produces its own magnetic field, like a solenoid. So then, this electrostatic energy decreases, magnetic potential energy increases. Then it becomes fully discharged. Capacitor becomes fully discharged. Then current decreases in the circuit. Now, inductor has problem with everything due to Lenz law. If current is decreasing, it will stop. It will oppose a decrease. So it will now convert its magnetic energy. It will convert its magnetic field lines into current and will support and will start charging the capacitor. Same process will be repeated again and again. So basically, the electrostatic potential energy that was stored in the capacitor oscillates between electrostatic potential energy and magnetic potential energy. Electrostatic potential energy in capacitor, magnetic potential energy in inductor. So these are the oscillations, LC oscillations. So what is the use of LC circuit? It produces LC oscillations. LC oscillations are electromagnetic signals. So yes, that was an important topic. Now we'll prove that in a total energy is conserved in an LC circuit. Total energy is conserved. This we will prove in an LC circuit. Because what is happening in the LC circuit? Energy is changing from electrostatic energy to magnetic energy, electrostatic energy in capacitor, magnetic energy in inductor. So we'll see that energy is conserved. So let us see. We are taking a fully charged capacitor initially. So maximum charge in it, we will give it a name, some name, Q naught. So initially, maximum energy in the capacitor is electrostatics, and it is equal to half CV square, Q square by C. So that charge is maximum. By initially, capacitor is fully charged. So that fully maximum charge, I'm denoting like this. There are three formulas for electrostatic potential energy. We all have done in chapter electrostatics. Those are half CV square, half Q naught square by C, and half QV. We require this. Keep it in mind, this is Q naught, maximum charge. Now, this is initially. And there is nothing in the inductor. Yes, there is nothing in the inductor. So inductor is empty. There is no magnetic potential initially. So UB is zero. So what is the total energy? You know the sum of this and this plus this. We know the sum, right? Now we will see at any time. At any time t, let charge in the capacitor be Q. So how much is the electrostatic potential energy at that time t? It's half Q square by C. And what is Q? Q is Q naught cos omega t. Why? Because I is in sign now, so Q will be C. This is general equation of SHM. Q naught cos omega t. In previous topic, we have seen this. This we have seen that there is a similarity. This is equation of SHM. So here x is Q. What used to be x? Recall chapter SHM, oscillations in waves. A cos omega t or A sin omega t. X. X means here Q. So I have taken x as Q as Q naught cos omega t. This is the value of instantaneous charge. And why I have taken in cos? Because current is in sign. Differentiation is in sign. So this will be cos. We can substitute here. So I'm ready with electrostatic energy present in the capacitor at any point of time. So let us substitute Q naught square cos square omega t. Now what is magnetic potential energy at that time in the inductor? This is in capacitor, and in inductor, do we know the formula? Yes, half Li square. This is magnetic potential energy stored in the inductor. Okay, so we'll substitute here half L. So I we can obtain by, let us obtain I by differentiating Q. So I is dQ by dt. Substitute Q. So Q naught out, cos ka differentiation is minus cos, sorry, cos differentiation is minus sine. And what is there with t will come out. So this is my I. Shall we substitute here? Minus q naught omega sine t omega t square. So this can be written as half L q naught square omega square sine square omega t. So let us find out total energy at time t. This electrostatic, this magnetic, so total, add both. This is half common, half here and half here, q naught square here and q naught square here. Here is cos square omega t. And here we have, let us see, it's L omega square. See, first of all, we have forgotten the C. This is here. So it is C is left, capacitance. So from here, what is left? Omega square and L. And then sine square omega t. Now, just now in previous topic, we have seen that the natural frequency of LC circuit is omega square is 1 by LC. So can we substitute here? 1 by LC. This is L. So LL will be cancelled, right? So it's 1 by C. So total energy would be equal to half Q naught square cos square omega t by C plus omega square is 1 by LC. This is L sine square omega t. So LL cancelled. Now C can be taken common as well. So half Q naught square by C. So cos square plus sine square, you know it's 1. So this is this. This is the total energy at any time t. And initially how much was the energy, total energy? That was also like this only. So that means energy remains conserved, but it keeps on oscillating from electrostatic potential energy in capacitor to magnetic potential energy in inductor. That is how LC oscillations are produced. So LC circuit is used as antenna because it emits oscillations, electromagnetic waves. Okay. So kindly prepare these topics.